This is Rich Nelson with Allendale, helping Mike with a special update as far as today's two USDA reports here. We did have two reports released here. Number one is the quarterly, what we call the grain stocks report. This one updates as supplies left over from last fall's harvest as of March 1. And for corn and soybeans, this now wraps up the first half of the marketing year. For wheat, which has a May 30th end of the marketing year, this actually wraps up three quarters of the marketing year for old crop here. As far as these grain stock numbers, all estimates actually were larger than expected here. USDA found 5.399 billion bushels of corn left over on and off farms as of March 1st. This was a sharp increase over the average guess of 5.013. So essentially, we learned that we have more corn on hand right now than expected, and therefore we imply that means weaker usage in the past quarter. Certainly, as far as this goes, feed use was the prime issue. With this large of an increase over the average guess, USDA certainly will be forced to drop their feed use number on next week's or on next month's monthly supply demand report. Ending stocks, which were a very tight 632 million bushels, could be raised as much as 300 million bushels here. So certainly a large increase coming here for ending stocks. As far as soybeans, the numbers were disappointing as well in the grain stocks report. 999 million bushels were found, a little higher than the average guess of 935 million bushels. So same story here. This implies usage in the past quarter was weaker, and therefore next month may be forced to raise its estimate of ending stocks numbers here. Keep in mind, last month they were using 125 million bushels. That may be raised moderately, perhaps anywhere from 20 to 50 million bushels on the April supply-demand report. For wheat, this grain stock number does represent the end of the third quarter. There's only one quarter usage left for wheat here. And that today's numbers at 1.235 billion bushels were about 57 million bushels higher than the average guess. So a little weaker usage also in the past quarter than expected. That will imply maybe a little bearish reaction as far as USDA's ending stock numbers on next month's report. So the main message was a sharp revision in expectations right now on old crop demand here. As far as new crop numbers, really we don't have a whole lot of surprises on the corn acreage. USDA found potential plantings here, 97.282 billion. That was actually almost right on the average guess. And then compared with last year, a slight increase, maybe of a little over 100,000 acres. So a slight increase in corn acres, but as we've noted before, the key issue on new crop supplies is not going to be acreage. It certainly will be yield. Using USDA or using Allendale's yield number, 157 bushels per acre, that gives a potential increase in production of a very large 3.2 billion bushels. And if you use USDA's very aggressive yield number, 163.6, that's going to imply a tremendous 3.8 billion bushel increase. As far as soybeans, we can point out there was a surprise as far as this acreage number. The trade had been looking for a 1.2 million acre increase in soybean ground, but USDA survey actually found a net decrease in acreage. 77.126 million was their number. That's actually a net decrease from last year. One thing we can look at here, while we have very burdensome corn numbers as far as the potential supplies, soybeans, this is a moderate increase implied. Over last year, looking around 282 million bushels. As far as wheat, wheat acreage issues, USDA basically told us around 704,000 extra acres over last year. That's using 56.44 million. So a net increase in wheat acres. We can point out a little surprise, as it implied certainly higher wheat or higher winter wheat, higher spring wheat, but actually posted a very sharp decline in durum of 372 million. If it weren't for that sharp decline in durum acres, we'd see over a million acre increase for wheat here. Now, we will point out, of course, there are some concerns about abandonment for winter wheat and also potential yields, as we do have spring rains right in front of us. So the trade's going to suggest, well, yes, we have a net increase in a net decrease in wheat production for this 2013 period using these numbers. But actually, if there is more abandonment, if there are some yield issues, we will see a net decrease even larger than that very moderate decline that's expected here. So the main message for today was certainly second quarter usage was much weaker than expected as far as old crop. USDA will be raising ending stock numbers on the April supply-demand report. Also, this implied that as far as 2013 supplies, we'll have adequate grain supplies for wheat and soybeans and burdensome supplies for corn. If you have any questions about this report, the market's reaction, or more importantly, what to do from trading or a marketing grain standpoint, feel free to give Allendale a call here. Our number is 1-800-262-7538. I look forward to answering any questions and helping you out as the season progresses.